Diegetic music, also known as source music, is music that exists in-universe in a work of fiction. Music that the characters hear, not just the audience. There are many popular pieces of diegetic music throughout pop culture, but Star Wars has some of the most famous of them all. In this video, my channel will live up to its name, and I will tell you about and play a brief excerpt from a dozen or so of my favorites. You're listening to Radio Free Coruscant, and these are the galaxy's greatest hits. Mad About Me, also known as the Cantina Band song, by Figrin Dan and the Modal Nodes. We'll start with the best of the bunch. Mad About Me, more commonly known as the Cantina Band song, is one of the most famous pieces of diegetic music in all of fiction. Nearly everyone who has ever seen Star Wars, and probably quite a few people who haven't, can instantly recognize this memorable tune. Mad About Me was written and performed by Figrin Dan and the Modal Nodes, a relatively obscure Bith band that played all around the Outer Rim. This song was playing when Luke Skywalker and Obi-Wan Kenobi entered the Mos Eisley Cantina on Tatooine to solicit transportation to Alderaan in 0BBY. It was by far the band's most popular song, and the only one to reach mainstream popularity. In real life, the song was composed when George Lucas asked John Williams to create a song that sounded like futuristic aliens trying to recreate the works of Benny Goodman. Symphonic Nabuala, by Augie's Great Municipal Band. The next song on our list is the Symphonic Nabuala, better known by its soundtrack title of Augie's Great Municipal Band. In-universe, it was a musical epic telling the story of the Naboo and Gungan defeat of the Trade Federation. It was written by a Gungan musicagung named Agara Jowl and played by the Great Municipal Band, which was made up of the finest musicagungs on Naboo. The reason I included it on this list, other than it being a sweet marching band piece, is that the choir is actually singing an upbeat version of Palpatine's theme. Take a listen. It is chilling to hear such an enthusiastic rendition of such a menacing villain's theme. Chicken in the Pot, by Arodia Ventafoli and Luleo Primark. Chicken in the Pot was a smooth and sultry piece sung by human singer Arodia Ventafoli and Galusian Luleo Primark. It was performed most famously aboard the Crimson Dawn flagship, the First Light, though the pair sang it in concerts across the galaxy as well. The song is sung in Huttese and depicts a conversation between the two singers about what to eat, with Ventafoli mentioning hamburger, cucumber, bolognese, and mayonnaise. Jabba Flow, by Shag Kava.
Oh, Jabba.
Jabba Flow was another Huttese song performed by the traveling band Shag Kava.
Oh, Jabba.
They played in Maz Kanata's castle in 34 ABY. Following this performance, they played their other hit song, Dabra Dumpa. In real life, Jabba Flow was written and performed by acclaimed composer Lin-Manuel Miranda and director J.J. Abrams. The pair met after a Hamilton performance where Miranda approached Abrams and offered to write cantina music if there was such a scene in the upcoming Star Wars movie. Abrams later reached out to Miranda and accepted his offer, and the two collaborated on the piece. Miranda remixed lyrics from a reggae fusion piece called It Wasn't Me and translated them into Huttese using a glossary he found online. The song's chorus, no bata tutu mooney mooney translates to whatever it is I didn't do it, lover lover, a line inspired by It Wasn't Me. The Real World song's artist, Shaggy, also inspired the name of Miranda and Abram's fictional band, Shag Kava. The two performed Jabba Flow live after a performance of Hamilton on May 4th, 2016.
No Jabba.
Sugan Asana by the Agasana. Fans of Jedi Fallen Order will recognize this memorable piece. It scored the opening scene of the game, with Cal Kestis listening to it as he went to work scrapping a ship on Braca. The song was also used later in the game by the Haxian Brood in their gladiator arena. The song was performed by a band called the Agasar. Behind-the-scenes enthusiasts will likely already know that in the real world, Sugan Asana was composed and sung by the Mongolian rock band The Who. The song was performed in an original Star Wars language created specifically for Fallen Order and incorporates elements of Mongolian culture and The Who's signature style. The name, Sugan Asana, means Black Thunder, and the song is about a warrior's heart and spirit as the power of thunder. In February 2022, The Who released a version of the song sung in Mongolian named Black Thunder. The Who also composed several other songs as their Star Wars analog, the Agasar, for the 2023 sequel to Fallen Order, Jedi Survivor. Glory of the Empire by Varius. First appearing in Star Wars Rebels, Glory of the Empire is the official national anthem of the Galactic Empire. As you can tell, it is a version of Vader's theme, the Imperial March, altered to sound patriotic for use in parades and before sporting events. Niamos, Morlana Nightclub, Coruscant Lounge, and Galaxy Mixes by Unknown Artist. The song Niamos by a currently unnamed musician kicked off Andor Season 1 with a bang. This song sounds exactly like the kind of thing you'd hear in a seedy nightclub and really set the tone for what to expect in Andor, both in terms of soundtrack and in the tone of the show. Then it returned mid-season in a chill lo-fi remix on Coruscant, and then in its original form on the surreal Floridian planet Niamos to ring in a new and unpleasant chapter in Cassian's life. Unto Stone Are We and Andor Episode 12 Title Theme by the Citizens of Ferrix. Keeping in Andor Season 1, Unto Stone Are We is the traditional funeral march played by the Citizens of Ferrix. In my opinion, it is one of the best tracks in the Andor score, a true masterpiece by Nicholas Britell. The entire season led up to this scene and it paid off spectacularly. The march is a haunting, sorrowful melody that audibly expresses the grief that the people of Ferrix feel over Marva's loss. Another thing that makes it unique and impactful is that it actually sounds like a real municipal band. They aren't professional musicians, they might not meet to practice very often, but they are still proud of their tradition and their music, and play it well. It adds so much to the incredible world-building of Ferrix. Plus, I just love marching bands. I was in band in high school and continue to go watch marching band competitions every fall, so I would be a fool to exclude this entry. The Ferrix Municipal Band also played the title theme for episode 12 of Andor. I was confused at first why they chose that sound for the intro of that episode, but it all made perfect sense after reaching the funeral scene. Make things even better, Unto Stone Are We incorporates elements of the Andor theme to tie it all together. Throne Room Theme, by presumably the Rebellion Marching Band. It isn't entirely clear whether or not the Throne Room theme from the end of A New Hope is diegetic or not, but if it isn't, they'd all be standing there in complete silence. That would be super weird, so let's assume this piece is really being played in the ceremony. I'm not sure who would be playing it, but perhaps there are enough musicians among the Rebellion's ranks to form a band. If Brasso survives Andor Season 2 and joins the Rebellion, perhaps he could be one of them. De Hutt Moda by Cy Snoodles. I almost didn't include this entry, but I decided that I had to. De Hutt Moda by Cy Snoodles is one of the many, many Indiana Jones references in Star Wars. It is a reference to the opening scene of The Temple of Doom, where Willie Scott sings a nearly identical song named Anything Goes. In fact, this is a bit of reference Inception because Willie is singing in Club Obi-Wan, a Star Wars reference within Indiana Jones. Namahe by Lackey Limbeng. I have a couple of songs to list from Oga's Cantina in Galaxy's Edge. All of the songs in R3X's jukebox are outstanding, especially the remix of Mad About Me, but I'll just showcase two of my favorites for now. The first is Namahe by Lackey Limbeng. The song doesn't have any lore to explain, but I like it because it shows what a pop song might sound like in Star Wars. It seems like just the thing that someone like Mon Mothma's daughter might listen to. Or at least someone of her age and demographics. Leeta herself is probably more into traditional Chandrilan music given her obsession with other Chandrilan customs. Una Dewey Dee by Kra Mer Five. It's a medieval drinking song, in space, sung by a drunken Gungan. What more do I need to say? 10 out of 10, no notes. I implore you to go listen to the whole thing yourself. We Speak No Huttese by Unknown. This honorable mention isn't remotely canon, but I discovered it while researching this video and just had to include it. We Speak No Huttese is, ironically, a Huttese translation of the real-world song We No Speak Americano by the Australian band Yolanda Be Cool. It featured in the game Kinect Star Wars for the Xbox 360. The game features other Star Wars-ified songs as well. Hologram Girl instead of Hollaback Girl, Empire Today instead of YMCA, and the oddly famous and absolutely ridiculous I'm Han Solo instead of Riding Solo. However, We Speak No Huttese is the only one of the bunch that really seems like it could conceivably be a real Star Wars song. Victory Celebration and Yub-Nub, Galactic Citizens and the Ewoks. The final entries on the list are Victory Celebration and Yub-Nub, the end songs for the two versions of Return of the Jedi. If you aren't aware, the theatrical release of Jedi ended with the Ewoks singing Yub-Nub, but it was replaced by Victory Celebration in the special editions. This has proven to be a fairly controversial move, but both versions are excellent and worthy of mention on this list. I don't really have anything else to say about them, they're just good. And with that, our exploration of diegetic music in Star Wars is complete. There are many, many more examples of it, far too many to discuss in one video, so if you enjoyed this music selection, I highly recommend you look up Star Wars diegetic music on YouTube and check out one of the playlists you can find. I would also even more highly suggest that you subscribe and let me know what your favorite piece of in-universe music is. I'd also love to hear if you'd be interested in a video about diegetic music from other franchises, specifically original pieces composed for one universe or another like these were, not real-world songs used diegetically. Leave a link to examples of it if you do. Anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll see you later. RFC out.